MyHeritage.com is one of those sites that lets you create family trees and look through old documents and all that. I found out that they've just introduced this tool called DeOldify, where you upload a black and white image and it automatically turns it into colour. I think it uses AI, deep learning technology or something. So I was really interested in this and I thought I'd give it a go. I didn't expect much because, you know, how can a thing accurately know what something would look like if it was in colour? Now the aim of this is that you're meant to upload black and white family photos or whatever, but I just downloaded a random picture of William Hartnell from Doctor Who instead. I put that in and I was really surprised by how well it came out. Really quick as well, it only took a few seconds. But what amazed me most was that, now maybe I'm just seeing things here, but to me it looked like it actually turned a TARDIS blue. A very dark blue, but it looks, at least to me, like there's at least a hint of blue there. And that amazed me because, yeah, I can imagine it's able to guess what colour people would have been, but to make the TARDIS blue as well, I thought that's pretty darn impressive. So then I frantically looked through my saved images to see what other black and white photos I had that I could colourise, and I only had one other, and it was a picture of Mussolini. Why do I have a picture of Mussolini on my computer, you might ask? I assure you there's a very good reason. So I put that through DeOldify, and it came out in colour alright, and then I remembered that when I found the original black and white photo on Google Images, I saw a version that was already in colour, that someone had presumably colourised in Photoshop or something. So I found that again to compare it, and you know, the DeOldify did an alright job considering it only took a few seconds to do what probably took someone else an hour or so to do manually. So then I was like, well, what do I colourise now? I'd done Mussolini, so the obvious answer was Hitler. Mainly because, considering I thought it turned a TARDIS blue, I was curious as to whether it would turn his armband red. Is it really that clever? Well, it turns out no. He came out looking like alternate universe Hitler, you know, like where he invaded Italy instead of Poland or something. I did find it interesting though that while it didn't make his armband red, it did make the parts surrounding it red, which is weird. So by this point I'd already uploaded 3 black and white photos and you know I'm impressed with the results, so by now naturally I'm already thinking, what happens if you put a colour photo into it? And this is the part that really amazed me. Now unfortunately, for many reasons, I can't show the actual photos that I used at this point, but I found alternatives and basically they were something like this. You know, one of those cosplay e-girls with the bright clothes and the wigs and all that. Why do I have a picture of cosplay e-girls on my computer, you might ask? I assure you there's a very good reason. So I put this through the DeOldifier and I was shocked. Look at what happens. Isn't that incredible? So I tried another one and look at that. So not only does DeOldify turn black and white photos into colour photos, it also turns e-girls into normal girls. I don't know about you, but I think that's pretty bloody amazing. So yeah, I just found that really fascinating and thought I'd share my discoveries with it basically. I've tested it out on a few more images, and while some images it does essentially nothing to, and others it completely changes it in ways you would have never expected. Now unfortunately, in my experimenting, eventually I discovered that there's a limit and each account can only colourise 10 photos using a DeOldify on MyHeritage before having to pay to do any more basically. But it's still a pretty amazing tool and really fun, so if you do want to try, I'd strongly recommend looking up DeOldify and giving it a go.